The label you've never heard of that dresses Meghan and Kate, founders of Canadian brand Smythe, reveal the impact of royals wearing their brand. Wearing an oversized blazer button low across her bare chest, tailored trousers and spiked stiletto heels, the woman in the photograph is utterly captivating. She rests a hand on her décolletage as a suggestive smile plays across her lips. Her hair is tousled and brown, kohl-rimmed eyes stare defiantly into the lens. That woman is Meghan Markle, and the readers of the October 2015 edition of The Base Ain't Bull, a lifestyle magazine published in Toronto, Canada, on whose front cover she appeared, didn't know it at the time, she would, in little under 3 years, go on to marry a prince. When Andrea Lenczner and Christie Smythe saw the images of the actress in the magazine, they were even more transfixed than most. "That's our blazer. I remember yelling to Christie. She's wearing our blazer," recalls Andrea, 46, a soft-spoken Toronto native and co-founder of women's wear brand Smythe. "It was a complete surprise to us to see Meghan in our jacket. She portrayed it exactly as we had imagined. It's manly, there's very little shaping in it, but she pulled it off with such elegance and femininity. By rolling up the sleeves and pairing it with big hair and smoky eyes, she made the whole look spectacular. It was very sexy. Very Meghan." The appearance of that £340 jacket in the magazine, and Meghan's subsequent love affair with Smythe clothing, would transform the label's fortunes. So much so, in fact, that Smythe, previously available only to Canadian and American shoppers, will soon be on sale in this country, with upmarket department store Harvey Nichols stocking some of Meghan's favorite pieces from their range later this month. If ever there was proof of the so-called Meghan effect, this is surely it. Fast forward 3 years from her first endorsement and she is no longer an actress but a duchess, with the fashion clout that comes with it. Every outfit she wears sells out in an instant, giving her the power to send sales soaring and help brands rack up lucrative profits. Though she has worn several Smythe garments over the years, from a woolen jumper out shopping in London to a suede jacket while dashing to and from a yoga class, Andrea and Christie first benefited from the Markle sparkle when she donned their £760 wool Brando coat for a walkabout with Harry in Brixton, South London, in January this year. "She's had the coat for years," Christie, 45, tells me, as the pair sit side by side in their bright workshop in the trendy West Queen West district of Toronto. She first wore it on the set of Suits, in 2016, dressed down with a baseball cap, jeans and loafers. Nobody took much notice. And then, when she was coming over to the UK to live with Harry, she packed her coat and brought it with her, just like any normal woman would. "When she wore it in London, it sold out in two colors before the end of the day," says Christie. "We reissued it straight away. We were getting online orders from all over the world, Asia, South America, Europe. It was brilliant." Meghan's high-profile patronage came again in April, when she wore their grey military pagoda coat, £740, pictured, to a poignant dawn service commemorating Anzac Day in London. As before, the coat, which isn't officially available to customers until October, sold out in pre-order sales. "Meghan is a classic dresser," says Andrea. "She's contemporary, she knows what suits her. She draws a lot of attention to her waist, so our belted and buttoned styles suit her. They're the sort of garments she can adapt to her new life, both smart and casual." Harvey Nichols will stock key pieces from Smythe's autumn collections from later this month.